When I was young, and I don't mean young like you, I mean like 12 or 13, I saw a zombie movie on cable TV, and it scared the crap out of me. And I've been terrified of zombies ever since. Because, you know, they don't obey the rules of conventional monsters. You know, most monster movies start with some very young, dumb people and a token black guy, and they make a bad choice. They say things like, oh, have you ever been to, like, Chernobyl? It was, like, the worst nuclear disaster ever. We should totally go check it out. And that's how most horror movies start. You know, Cabin in the Woods. How would you go to a cabin in the woods? Zombie stories, they come to you, and they're global, and you could be minding your own business, and suddenly trouble comes knocking. And that absolutely flipped me out. So I'd been thinking about that ever since.
Do you remember what film it was?
Yes, yes. The name has changed many times. It was an Italian cannibal zombie movie, and it was made sort of in the wake of Dawn of the Dead, and it was about... it starts with an Italian commando unit, which should be a comedy. This Italian commando unit goes to New Guinea to find the source of a plague, and they end up stumbling into the zombie apocalypse. And I'm 99% sure that the filmmakers used documentary footage of actual ritual cannibalism in New Guinea and spliced it in. Yeah, yeah. When you're 12 and you see that, that tends to stick with you. So very gory, very horrible. I mean, there was a scene where, like, there's a dead old lady in a wheelchair and a cat jumps out of her stomach. I mean, I'm 12. You know, the worst thing that happens to you at 12 is, like, hairs growing in weird places and you have weird new feelings. And that's about it. And suddenly, cannibal zombies, yeah, that sticks with you.
So apart from that, it maybe like more recently, what do you think is the best or the scariest visualization of zombies that's been done?
Other than Dawn of the Dead, the original Dawn of the Dead, which is the greatest zombie movie ever made, I would have to say recently Shaun of the Dead. Because not only is it a great comedy, not only is it a great zombie movie, it's a great movie. You know, I think that zombie movies are best when they have social commentary, when they sort of encapsulate what's happening in the world. Like the original Dawn of the Dead talked about that generation of Americans that started off idealistic and then ended up as the most materialistic generation in America's history. Bam. Perfect. Well, to me, Shaun of the Dead is kind of like the Clerks of that generation for the UK. I mean, it really did sort of summarize what it meant to be British and young at that point. And I thought that movie should be taught in history classes. Like if you're teaching a sociology class and you say, all right, Britain, we had the imperial times and then we had sort of the hippies and the swinging 60s and then we had the punk era and then we had Thatcher and then we sort of had this kind of malaise afterwards. And here it is, Shaun of the Dead. So that's why I love that movie. And by the way, I know Simon Pegg and he's a genuine zombie fan. He's not, a lot of these guys are jumping on the bandwagon, not him.
Zombies sell, though, right? Seems to be everyone.
Oh, my God. Now, please, when people smell money, they come running, which is ironic because when I wrote Zombie Survival Guide back in the late 90s, zombies could not have been farther off the radar. I mean, the at least in my country, the most popular thing was a young kid sodomizing an apple pie. That was, you know, what people went to the movies to go see.
So why did you then create something about zombies?
Well, because I was scared of them. And I went looking for a zombie survival guide because I had thought of it constantly. What would I do realistically? Forget what you see in the movie. So I thought, well, there's got to be a book out there. There's got to be someone who's as much of a loser as me who spends way too much time thinking about this. And the truth was, nobody was that much of a loser except me. So I thought, party on. I'm going to write it myself.
Why do you think everyone is so obsessed with zombies and the apocalypse at the moment?
Well, I mean, I do think we're living in sort of uncertain times right now. But I think if you tell stories that are too real, like about Ebola, people aren't going to want to look at that because that triggers the defense mechanisms where people go, oh, that's too scary. That's too real. But if you make it a metaphor or if you couch it in a fictional catalyst like zombies, then you can do all the wonderful things that you saw in the Brixton riots. But because it's zombies, people still look at it and say, oh, that's smashing. Oh, 28 days later, I'm going to sleep. And then that's fine. But if you make it real, then people say, oh, good Lord, no. And then they turn off.
And are you promoting anything in particular this weekend?
This weekend we've got two projects. We've got from Avatar here, the Extinction Parade Volume 2, and that is the ongoing story of a zombie plague told through the eyes of vampires. And then from Duckworth, we've got the Harlem Hellfighters, which is a graphic novel, and it is a true story about the First World War. In 1917, a unit of African-American soldiers were set up to fail by their own government. And after being humiliated and sabotaged, they ended up coming home as one of the most decorated units in the whole U.S. Army. And nobody knows about them. It's a very well-kept secret, so I wanted to write about them.